You know, I think we can all agree that the 45 ACP just sucks. I mean, it is an outdated, antiquated, and pretty much useless round. The only guys that actually still support this round are the type of guys that have to tape their sack to their inner thigh so that they're not sitting on their balls all day. So I think we can all agree as tactical people here that anyone that would buy a 45 ACP is crazy, which is why I went out and bought this. A 45 ACP. More specifically, it's an FNX 45 Tactical. Now this is, like I said, a 45 ACP chambered firearm. It holds 15 plus one rounds. This is the Flat Dark Earth model. I used to have the black model, but I sold it, so I got this one to replace it. Now this gun is cut for reflex red dot sights, an RMR. Right here you can see the plate where it is already cut for it. It also has a threaded barrel for a suppressor, and it does have suppressor height sights on it already. This is a pretty awesome gun. Now it does have a manual safety and decocker on it, but you can convert this to a decocker only if you so choose. So it would be good for a carry gun. I actually still have the holster I had for my original one for this gun, so I could carry it if I wanted to, but that's not what I bought it for. I bought it for putting a suppressor on it and putting a red dot on it. But if I wanted to carry it, I could. Now, a lot of people would say, well, why would you carry a 45 ACP? The 45 ACP is such a horrible round. It's so slow that if you had to shoot at a bad guy and they were any distance away, by the time it got there, you know, they've going to have been wandering on about their day. They're not even going to be there anymore. And probably a disabled person or a nun is going to wander in and you're going to hit them by mistake. And luckily, it's a 45 ACP, so you'll just give them a nasty bruise, but you still don't want that happening. So why would you carry a 45 ACP? Well, the reason I would carry it is because it's still an awesome gun. It's an awesome round. I said before that it's not the best round in any category, but it's still a time-proven and amazing round. No one can tell you different. The 45 ACP has proven itself time and time again, and like I said, no one can contradict that. Which brings me to my point here. I never said the 45 ACP was no good. In fact, in those videos where I talked about how the 45 ACP isn't the best at anything, I started the videos by saying, out of the acceptable, proven self-defense rounds, the 45 ACP is the one that has no real advantages over every other round. It's not the best at anything. That doesn't mean it's not good. You know, a Toyota Land Cruiser may not be the best off-road vehicle. A Jeep Wrangler can get in and out of places that a Toyota Land Cruiser can't, a modern Land Cruiser. And on-road, it's not the most comfortable vehicle. You can find more comfortable vehicles. You can find vehicles that perform better. There's nothing that that Land Cruiser will do better than some other vehicle. I mean, that can do better than any other vehicle. There's always some vehicle that will beat it in every category, but that doesn't mean it's still not a great all-around vehicle. And it is. It's a great all-around vehicle. The 45 ACP is the same thing. It's a great all-around round. It just doesn't have any big advantages over other rounds. It's still very acceptable, very well performing. It doesn't penetrate better than other rounds. There's other rounds that penetrate better. It doesn't move faster than other rounds. There's rounds that move faster. It doesn't produce the best wound cavity. There's rounds that produce better wound cavities. You know, if there's just anything you say that a self-defense round has to do, this round, the 45 ACP, doesn't do it best. It's never a 10 in any category. The good thing about it is it's like an 8 in every category. Some rounds will be like a 10 in one category and like a 2 and a 1 in others. The 45 ACP is pretty much an 8 straight across the board. Now, another round, like say you take a 9mm, now it might beat out the 45 ACP in some categories. But when you add all the categories together, it might average out to a 6 or a 7 on a scale from 1 to 10, whereas the 45 ACP is still an 8. So it might be better overall. It just doesn't win in any single category. I've never understood why 45 ACP guys get so upset whenever you point this out. It's like they have no self-esteem, that they don't value their own opinion enough to be comfortable in their own opinion, to hear when someone else says something that they think might contradict their opinion, that they can listen to it and go, yeah, okay, I can give you that part, but still my favorite round. They get immediately defensive. So I just wanted to make this video today for two things. One, to show you my new gun, and two, to tell you, I never said the 45 ACP sucks, I just said it's not best at anything. That doesn't mean that it's not one of the best rounds you can possibly choose. Motherfucker, it would help if I actually hit record. Why do I keep doing that?
My real dad.